Welcome back to TAC Cup Future Stars. We'd love to have a look at family stories here on the program through the course of the year. You know, close to home for Sweeney Estate Agents, the can-do agents, and you can visit Sweeney Estate Agents for all of your real estate needs. It's been a very emotional year, it must be said, for the Essendon Football Club and, of course, for the sad and tragic passing of Merv Neagle, one of their superstar footballers of the 80s. Merv Neagle was tragically taken from us in a truck accident only last year. His son Jayden lives his legacy, having a wonderful year in the TAC Cup competition as a medium forward. And this week, in the middle of a very busy year for Jayden, he sat down and talked to Tristan Fernanda.
Proving to like recruiters and stuff like that, showing them that you can play and wanting to get on to the next step, next game.
What's one thing you think you can take away from this experience?
Going 100%, 100% of the time. Intensity has to be up, like that'd be with life as well, just to go flat out all the time.
What do you see as being your main strengths as a player?
Trying to compete, kicking goals, just competing really.
You played TAC Cup footy with the Murray Bush Rangers. What do you enjoy most about playing in the TAC Cup?
Definitely the challenge, like being all around Australia and that. I played in some really poor leagues and stuff like that, and then able to like challenge yourself with a good team against other good teams is what I find best.
Kids from the Murray region travel far and wide. How much of an issue is it in terms of gelling as a group?
Yeah, definitely. Like, we got the biggest range, I think, in TAC Cup, from all the way from Shepparton to me at Walla. And it's hard only meeting. We only meet twice a week. Game day and training once Wednesday night, so yeah, that's pretty hard.
Sadly, last year you lost your father in a road accident. How devastating was that for you and the family?
Oh, well, it's still not over it. You still think about it every day. It's still very hard. Mum still struggles a bit, but where we are in Wallow has really helped, being in a small community like that, which is really good.
How much of an influence was your dad on your footy career?
Oh, yeah. Ever since I could walk, it was just had a foot in my hand, because we travelled a lot. He was coaching, just learnt the game, and just he wasn't really in my face or anything like that. Just watching him and learning off him was a big help.
How much support has your family been during this period?
We still have the odd fight, which is what expected from brothers, I suppose. But definitely teammates help a lot. Yeah.
Life outside of footy, you've started a building apprenticeship. How's that going?
Pretty challenging getting up, because I'm in Wallow and I work in Wodonga, which is a 40-minute drive again, so I'm up at 20 past six, you know, and then going to work and then finishing work early and get on the bus and home at by 10, 11 o'clock that night. It's very challenging.
People around the traps say that you've got a great football brain. Do you think that'll hold you in good stead come draft time?
Yeah, definitely. Just you gotta have physical stuff for footy, but then as they say, 95% of it is mental, which I find a bit of a strength for me. Yeah.
Essendon hopes to foster its father-son relationships. Tell us about the James Hird Academy.
Oh, it's just a function every school holidays to get all the father sons involved in the club. Just go down for 2 days and have a bit of a kick with the other boys and just catch up, really, just get involved in the club.
You've had a hard run with injuries as well over the past 12 months. How have you managed those?
It was tough, like sitting on the sideline for the rest of the year. That was the hardest thing. But then started running again in December or January. And then just from there, just very slowly made my way back up and playing now.
The Murray Bush Rangers is a fantastic operation run by Andrew Carson and Darren Ogier. How do you find playing footy at that club?
Very, very effective because of the radar that we have. So we're so far away from each other, and being able to have only two days together, which is a very good setup, I reckon, works here.
Jayden Neagle there in his story on his quest to become an AFL player via the TAC Cup. Extraordinary, sad story, isn't it? And what an inspirational young guy, the way he's going about it, Shifter.
Oh, yes, and he's had a terrific year too. Really improved after missing half of last year. And as a 184-centimetre medium forward, he's got a special leg on him, as they say in SA. Wonderful kick at goal, great radar, like his father.
We wish him luck and the whole family for the remainder of the year.